this week on Chicago Beer Pass, the events seem like they're back in full swing, and there's a lot of beer news happening. Dive into some of that and a lot more on this week's episode.
Yeah, because, you know, you got a cork popped out, boom, it flies like fucking 10 feet. We're like, yeah, let's do it.
The legend, Mr. Pete Crowley. I love Pete Crowley, man.
How's that beer? It's what you think it is.
It'll be like the stuff you hear. Every time you go to Floyd's, all the music sounds like this. Rah, rah, rah!
Hey, and welcome to Chicago Beer Pass. I'm Brad Chmielewski.
Hi, I'm Nik White.
And he's very proper today. Feeling it's a sophisticated day, I guess, right?
Sophisticated and studious and so on and so forth.
So if you're new to Chicago Beer Pass, just what we do here is we drink a beer, local beer, we review that.
We'll
let you know about some of the events we've made it to over the past week. Hopefully we made it to something. And then next week, we share some of the events coming up that you should be checking out, especially if you're here in Chicago or thinking about visiting Chicago, too.
Yeah.
As well as a few events that maybe are coming up later in the calendar that you need to get tickets for. But like I said, we always start things off with a beer. And this time, I got some cans from Miskatonic.
Yeah, Miskatonic out in Darien, Illinois. So this is a session rye pale called Catchpenny. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Didn't know they were in cans yet, man. Didn't know they were in production at all, really.
In
packaging.
In packaging. You know? Yeah, yeah, I didn't know they were packaging yet either. I have seen them a few times at festivals and events and things like that. And
yeah, last year they were at Brewer's Eve.
Right,
they were one of those breweries. Yeah, we took a trip out there last summer. Yeah, cheers to Chef Juan Kim. He's a graphic artist as well. Uh-huh. So he all the artwork in there, he's responsible for that. So we took the Metro out there and hung out one day.
Oh, cool. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, they have this, like, from their cans, they have this, like, Victorian kind of feel.
Yeah, and I think the Miskatonic refers to, like, the Miskatonic River, which is, like, an imaginary river in the literature world. You know, and the book nerds are probably like, it's this author right here. But, yeah, he's, like, a popular author. I'm not familiar with his work.
No, okay. And these are, like, legit cans, too. Like, they're not, like, the shrink wrap plastic kind of things on them. Like, these are fully printed on there, so yeah. Look nice.
If you ever I think their logo, which is this this old Victorian lady with the umbrella and her long dress, and she's like part woman, part like creature, sea creature.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yeah, like, so her tentacles are coming out from under her dress, and there's a huge mural of that on their garage. If you ever need something to do on like a getaway, you know, from your normal routine, I suggest going out there to Darien. You know, Naperville's out there, you know, there's a handful of breweries out that way. So
Darien's by Naperville, sort of.
Yeah. They were saying these guys are, I know one of them's a former Goose Island guy. He was former Goose Island and former, what's the name of that place, man? The one where, Pop Fest.
Oh, you guys, Rock Bottom?
Yeah. Yeah.
Rock Bottom Warrenville?
Yeah.
Okay.
So
nice. But the beer, it took me, I would say, 5 or 6 sips to warm up to this. Like, you're already like halfway through this.
Yeah, they're taking session pale to a new plateau here.
Yeah, I like
it's very sessionable.
Yeah, I took a sip and I couldn't figure out, like, was something wrong with my glass? Is it dirty? Is it did I have something else in here beforehand? But it didn't taste like a beer, I guess.
Yeah, almost like it's a very subtle approach to the beer,
yeah.
Right, to a rye pale. Very subtle.
Usually with rye, you kind of get some of that, like, spicy malt kind of characteristic coming through. I get none of that. Like, it's almost getting to, like, a cider kind of mouthfeel taste. Not that it's tart or infected or anything like that. It just has that, palate cleansing carbonation to it. I don't know.
Yeah, well, the first thing that comes to mind is like a little, like the way you would like a it's beer flavored beer.
Okay.
Yeah, almost seltzery, and yeah, kind of tickles the mid palate a little bit.
Uh huh. But there's like, I don't want to say that there's like nothing going on here, but it's just like so subtle and you almost forget you're drinking something. And maybe that's good and it is a session, so you kind of keep going back and you're kind of like, I want another sip. But you almost need to take like big drinks. Like you can't sip on it. You have to like gulp it.
Yeah, it's refreshing and understated, which, you know, are things you don't usually associate with a rye pale.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, so it's different for sure.
But yeah, nice to see them in packages, so check them out if you see them in the store or anything like that. I picked this up at Miska's down the street, and not totally sure how long they've been on the shelves for, so yeah, maybe someone else.
There's no code on the bottom of this thing.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, oh, it says they use a German all yeast strain for fermentation. Interesting. Yeah, very cool. Looking forward to seeing what more of their beers come out in the future. So this past week, yes. I don't know. I fell apart.
You laid low?
I laid low, yeah. I went over to Burnt City at some point.
Right on.
Had some beers there, but, you know, we've talked about them many a times. Had them on as guests and had their beers on here, so yeah. Yeah, nothing new to report from going there.
It's always a solid choice. They got the beautiful, they got the old school bowling alley. They got the beautiful French beer art, turn of the century beer art over there. Mm-hmm. Nice space. One of our flagship spaces for a long time.
For the brew bus?
For the brew bus, yeah.
Nice. Other than that, yeah, no, nothing else for me. What about you? Do you make it out to any drinking related things?
Yeah, I found myself at the museum, the Field Museum downtown. Which is, you know, they're trying to get a beer program going. So they got Off Color Beer, Tooth and Claw, which is exclusively for them.
Okay.
They actually had a tattoo of, exhibit, which was cool. So Sailor Jerry, the guy behind the rum, it was his birthday. So they invited a guy from Spike TV to come out and, you know, do tattoo exhibits in the tattoo exhibit.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah. So that was cool. So I hung out with the Sailor Jerry's guys and had some of their cocktails.
Nice.
Yeah.
Tooth and Claw, though, you can get elsewhere.
You can get anywhere, yeah. It's just they're saying it's, like, for them, but it's everywhere.
Yeah.
I'm excited about Pseudo Sue, which is the brewery Toppling Goliath from Iowa. That's going to be another beer that they add to their collection. Right now, they've got Goose IPA, their local brews. Goose IPA, Great Lakes.
Okay.
And like another brewery. I wrote it down. Yeah. Okay. But there's like four, but none of them are local.
Oh, that's too bad. Kinda,
yeah. It was like, I mean, they're local, like they're Midwest local.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. But,
so how was the rum?
So I went to that. I like that rum.
Okay.
You know, it's a spiced rum. So, and then apparently Sailor Jerry's like really into tattoo art, like all the artwork on the bottles are tattoos that he has, you know, that kind of thing.
Okay.
So. That was a fun time. Oh, yeah. Christmas Ale by Bales. God damn. Elliot Ness from Great Lakes. And, Tooth and Claw from All Color.
Okay.
It's weird because they need to have the Great Lakes Christmas Ale. That's the one you want.
Yeah, that's better than Bales Christmas Ale.
Yeah, that's where you want to be. Yeah. But, I mean, they're making an attempt to have a craft program, which is kind of cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that was good.
Anything else to check out?
No, that was a lone event I went to.
Man, we fell apart. Both of us fell apart this week. We didn't make it to anything. There was also not a lot of events going on. There was a few things, but nothing like really that jumped out or like you had to go check out.
Right? Yeah, I think everyone's still in a haze from, you know, like the holidays and then the New Year's Eve kind of thing.
Yeah. But yeah, so part of Chicago Beer Fest is definitely talking about the events coming up. And when they are happening, I know last week and our lost episode that didn't get recorded and posted online, that didn't have too many events either. But this week, it looks like they're picking up again, right?
Yeah, I think we're back in the swing of winter events, which is good to see. So
I guess starting off this week, anything happening before the weekend that, you know, people should be wetting their palate with?
Let's see. Where should we start here? Brooklyn Brewery is in town this week. So on Thursday, the 19th from 5 to 9, they're going to be at the J. Parker. J. Parker looks like it's the bar inside of the Hotel Lincoln, which is, you know, right there across the street from Lincoln Park. So they're going to have ghost bottles there. So ghost bottles are these bottles that are not labeled, that they don't sell, right?
Okay.
Yeah, they're going to have those bottles as well as Black Ops. So it's like a rotating series just amongst, like, you know, just beers that they give out to their friends, essentially.
So are they, are they like test beers? Like, I know Goose Island, I've been to many events of Goose Island employees where they have test beers. Like, that's part of their cases that they can get as employees. You can either get, like, the normal stuff, or, hey, we got this test beer we're trying out. Like,
exactly, yeah. I think it's similar to that. And then, like, I wouldn't be surprised if, like, you know, feedback from one of their ghost bottles ended up, like, in production.
Okay.
So it looks like they've got four beers coming out. The Passion of the Mango is one, and Dark Matter is another. And then the Black Ops. Black Ops is a beer they're going to have on tap there.
And Black Ops is such an underrated beer.
Yeah, I want to say that's one of their barrel-aged stouts, right?
It's a definitely stout. I don't remember if it's barrel-aged or not, but it was this beer that fell under the umbrella, like, when I know I was getting into craft beer, it was, like, that and Speedway Stout and Bourbon County Stout. These were, like, your big and blackout stout from Great Lakes. Like, this is big, bold winter stouts that, like, you might be able to get your hands on, but everyone want it.
Yeah, the Abyss. That whole class of 88 really does a good job with stouts. You know, like, let's see, there's Goose, there's Brooklyn Brewery.
Great Lakes,
and Deschutes.
Yeah.
All came out in 1988, all doing underrated stuff. I went to a BYOB this week, and the first thing I did was grab a couple, like, local option one, you know, from Brooklyn Brewery.
Oh, nice.
Which is like their, you know, like their dark Saison with, like, honey. Yeah. Cool. I like their stuff. It's the bottle, man. I like the classic cork and cage, you know, bomber, you know.
Yeah, I think in Brooklyn, I think they're looking for a new space or something too. I don't follow the Brooklyn brewery story that well, not being in the area.
No, they were in there. They find themselves in town quite a bit. I know over the summer they did something at Two in West Town, the restaurant Two, and they were saying how they do. They're outgrowing their neighborhood. So their neighborhood's complaining that, hey, there's all these, you got all these people here, you got all these equipment, all these deliveries, you know.
Right.
And so they need to move to a space closer to, like, the water.
They need a packaging, they need a place that no one can go to, and then they need, like, the, hey, this is the brew pub, hey, come hang out
kind of thing. I think 40% of all the beer they make, you know, goes overseas. So they, like, literally want to be next to water so they can ship. So they can ship easier. Yeah. So there's talk of, like, a space in Staten Island, and they got a space in Brooklyn by the river.
Cool.
Yeah. So.
All right. So that's Thursday.
Yeah. Also Thursday, local option is taking over Kuma's.
Okay.
Yeah. So this is the original Kuma's. So it looks like five beers, and then you can get flights. They're going to be raffles. They're raffling off, like, the whole discography from Meshuga. I'm guessing Meshuga is some kind of metal band, knowing local Ashen guys and the Kumas guys.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah, but it's a chance to check out. A lot of people don't know, you know, they kind of fly under the radar with regards to, like, all the beer that they make, you know. And they won't reveal where they're making it, but they have,
so,
like,
secretive.
They have, like, six or seven beers. Like, whenever they do an event, you go to their towers at the local option bar, and one of the towers is dedicated to their beer. Yeah. Sometimes it's up to eight draft lines, you know?
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's Thursday. I know I've gone to events on Friday, like, afternoon for lunch, because my office, the office we record in here, isn't that far from Kuma's. So, and you can kind of sometimes get some of those beers still. So maybe I'll pitch that to the guys here. Let's take a walk over to Kuma's on Friday.
Yeah.
It is like 50 degrees in January, so.
Dude, yeah, it's going to be like in the 40s all week. It's beautiful. I love it. Yeah. American Muscle from them, I think, is a solid double IPA. I'd put that up with any other locally produced double IPA.
Okay.
From the local option guys. Yeah. The Long Room is turning 17 this week. This is awesome. We're still on Thursday.
Whoa.
Yeah.
That's 17? That's
cool. Yeah. That was quick.
Yeah. Man.
I really like the Long Room. Super small spot, and it really is, like, really narrow, one long walkway.
Right, yeah. It's a funny spot.
Yeah. I know they just opened up, like, a restaurant next in the space next door to it. Oh, but for their birthday party, they're rolling out $4 drafts. Everything's $4.
Okay.
Which nowadays, you know, I've been seeing, like, eight everywhere I go, everything's like $7-$8.
Yeah, it's kind of, beer's getting expensive, right?
Yeah. So that's like a throwback price, man. And then they're all 50, you know, basically the top 50 breweries in the country, you know. Lagunitas Founders, Allagash, Revolution all be represented at that event. Yeah, speaking of Revolution, they are throwing their Straight Jacket release party on Thursday. Straight Jacket is their barrel-aged barley wine.
Barrel-aged barley wine, okay. Man, everything's happening Thursday this week. What?
Ain't it great?
It's like, what's going on with Thursday this week? That's
Dude, I'm all about weekday parties. All about it.
So Straight Jacket release. Is this at the production brewery or at the brew pub?
This is at Kedzie. Oh, okay. Kedzie Tap Room from 5 to 10. So you can get bombers for sale, and then they'll also have all the varietals on tap. They got a Nitro Straight Jacket this year. And a few other varietals. They'll have some foods to match. Yeah, that ought to be a good time. You can also get Deeth Tar and Cafe Deeth if you missed out on those bottles.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nice. Okay. Yeah. Man, Thursday's going to be busy, I think. I think Thursday I'm going to go to Revolution, and then Friday for lunch I'll go to Kuma's for this local option thing.
Yeah, I haven't been to either one of those places in a long time. I might be right there with you, but let's see.
So anything else on Thursday or jump into the weekend?
No, let's jump into the weekend, man. The 17th Annual Brewpub Shootout is this weekend. This is the Chicago Beer Society. This year's event is going to be at Baderbrau. Usually they have this event at the – you went to this last year, right?
I went to this. This was at Art Center.
The Boot Zoo B.
Yeah.
Art Center down in Bridgeport.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, I went last year. That was the first time I had went. It had been an event that was kind of like on my list of events people talked about, like, this was a great time, and right. You see photos, you're like, how come I always forget about this event? And here I am again. I forgot to get tickets, and I'm not going. So it's always a good time because they do a theme. They have a food. I don't remember what the theme last time was, but it was a lot of tacos.
Yeah.
But it wasn't tacos wasn't the theme. I think it was like pork. Or sometimes it could be chocolate, or it could be peanut butter, or anything like that. And then everyone makes a food, and then they have their beers. They may pair the food with the beer, they may not.
Yeah, I like how at that event, the pairings happen, you know, with the brew pubs usually, right? You know, the kitchen and the brewer. But then if there's breweries that don't have a kitchen, they partner with a local restaurant sometimes. Cool.
Yeah.
Courtney from Revolution. Well, she was at Revolution.
Yeah.
And she was at Three Floyds. Mm-hmm. She's a pastry chef. She won this event 3 years in a row with pastries. Yeah.
It's kind of like the grown-up version of Beer Fly Alley Fight.
Yeah. That's a very fair comparison, for sure.
So that's Saturday. So, yeah, check that out. If you got tickets for that, I know that there's a lot of other things going on this weekend around politics and things like that. So if you just want to drink, you might want to check that out.
Yeah, and it's at Baderbrau, which if you haven't been there, they got the parking situation fixed. So they changed the coding on the street there.
Nice.
Yeah, so you can park right in front of the building.
That's
now.
Probably a result of us talking about it.
Chicago Beer Pass changing legislation.
Yeah, change happens here.
You still, yeah, man. So that ought to be good, man. Cheers to Baderbrau, too, for scoring that event. That's a big score for them.
Yeah, definitely. So that's Saturday. Anything else happening over the weekend?
Yeah, also on Saturday, the Beer Bistro is throwing their fourth annual Stout Takeover.
The one and only Beer Bistro.
Yeah, so I guess the other one's closed.
Yeah.
Right? Because there was one in Lincoln Park.
Yeah. Small bar Fulton.
Yeah, it was Small Bar Fulton, and then it closed. That sucks, because that's where the Color Money was filmed.
At that space?
It's a dope space, you know?
It is a great space.
It's for some reason, it's the oddest thing. It's like a dead spot, you know? You're on fucking Fullerton. You're at a major intersection. Like Fullerton and Southport's not too major. But it's in between Ashland and Halsted. There's a lot going on over there.
Right, but there's no... It's hard to get to, right, if you're on foot.
Yeah, I think most people... DePaul's right there.
Yeah.
And I think if you're a DePaul kid, you probably party east on Lincoln and hit the $3... bars.
Yeah.
And no one really goes to Southport. But for some reason, local option seems to be doing just fine. And they're basically like on a residential block.
Yeah.
Which is like weird. I will never understand local option ever. Like they're on a they're a metal bar on a residential block in Lincoln Park that sells
Cajun food.
And they're consistently one of the
every beer is at least $8.
I don't understand it at all. And it all seems to work.
Yeah.
You can't. I don't know how they're pulling that off. Oh, so this is the Beer Bistro, the original one in West Loop.
I'm Madison.
I'm Madison, yeah. So let's see, all the Goose Island stuff, Founders, Boulevard, like four or five Pipeworks beers, which is nice. Yeah, and Beer Bistro is a fun space. They got the front bar, the back bar. They even have a downstairs bar.
Mm-hmm.
The original Beer Bistro is pretty solid right in West Loop.
Definitely, yeah. So yeah. Check that out.
So that's on Saturday. Whew, we got a lot going on here, man. Let's see, what else is on Saturday? Temperance, Might Meets Right launch party is on Saturday.
So this is their newest can, that beer that got canned.
They got canned in it? Right on.
Yeah, so this beer just went into cans recently. I believe this was the beer that just went into cans.
Yeah, so this is their barrel-aged stout. So they
the different beer got canned.
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, so a new beer is in cans coming out. Maybe it's not that one.
I had an 18th Street Hunter, which is their double stout.
I thought we were talking about Temperance.
We are talking about Temperance. I was just thinking, I could see barrel-aged stuff getting canned. That wouldn't surprise me at all.
Okay, so maybe, but Temperance does have a new can, but maybe this one isn't it. Now I'm like blanking on which one it is. Okay, but Might Meets Right is their barrel-aged stout.
Yeah, so barrel-aged stout, and this year they got like four versions of it. Maple, coffee, vanilla, and then the original,
mm-hmm.
Right? They're going to have the Happy Lobster is going to be there. Fantastic food truck, the Happy Lobster.
Oh, Evan. Yeah. I haven't had that one.
This will all be up in Evanston. This is on Saturday at 4 p.m.
Cool.
Yeah.
So check it out. It's supposed to be really nice that day. So if you're looking for something to do, they have a nice outdoor space that you can kind of hang out at on their patio and things like that. It might be chilly, but it'd still be nice for January.
For sure. Mike Meeks, right? The Bolvadere version took a bronze medal at FOBAD back in 2015.
What's the Bolvadere version?
That's a great question. I knew you were going to ask that too.
It's like the Belvedere. It's the Fresh Prince version of...
Oh man, what is the Belvedere version? I don't know.
It must have been, is that just the type of barrel or type of booze that it was in? It had to have been, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So
that's Saturday up in Evanston. You also have a sketchbook that's not that far, so if you're up that way, you can definitely hit up a couple breweries, a couple trips, as well as Few is up there, so check that out.
Yeah, Evanston's got a lot going on up there. Smiley Brothers is up there.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like Bolvadere is one of the High West Distillery variants. It's like a whiskey variant.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Interesting.
So.
Cool.
All right.
Any other events on the calendar?
No, I think that's it.
That's it, okay. It's nice to see these events coming back. I know tickets are either on sale now or going to be on sale for the Chicago, Beer Classic. Is that what it's called? The one at Soldier Field.
Yeah.
Because that happens in, I think it's early March that goes on.
That's a nice space. You get to see the VIP room in at Soldier Field.
Yeah.
And then you get, it's all in the concourse. You can walk down on the, not, you can't walk on the field, but
yeah.
You can?
Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome.
It was on the field last year.
Then they're doing a lot better than this one I went to.
Right.
That you couldn't walk on the field.
But you went during the season.
I think
March,
you're right.
The season is over. It's done. Sense. So they're not as worried about the field. They would like want to keep it nice.
I'm trying to do my touchdown dance, man. I'm trying to bring a football, do my dance. Have Brad throw me like a 60-yard bomb.
Yeah, so we need to see if we can get some media passes for that.
I want to go to that.
Go check that out. It's a pretty fun event.
Yeah, that sounds fun.
So, but you can get tickets now. That's for sale, so check that out.
Right on.
Should we jump into some beer news before we wrap up here?
Yeah. What do we have here in beer news, man? Hopslam hit stores this week. Hopslam is the big badass double IPA with honey from Bell's.
In cans.
It's in cans this year. Yeah. I really enjoy that beer. That's one of the first beers that got me into beer, I think.
Right.
Yeah.
Are you going to chase after? Are you going to try to find it, or are you just going to hope that you run into it?
Yeah, I'm kind of hoping that the latter.
Okay.
Yeah. You know, if I roll into Jules, apparently Jules is like big on craft beer all of a sudden. It's like becoming like, you know,
the spot.
Yeah. Right. For like big beer releases. So I'm just plowing through this Catchpenny.
Well, yeah, there's nothing to it. Yeah. Right.
Yeah. I might, after this, I might go check out Jules and see if they've got any.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a good beer. I mean, you know, those beers, for the most part, you know, like Bourbon County Stout or Hop Slam, you know, the big, those big annual releases don't really change a whole lot. And some beers are caught up to them, but they're still delicious.
Yeah, for sure. So check out, get some Bell's Hop Slam if you can.
Yeah. The good folks at Off Color are releasing a beer this week at their bottle shop called Class War. So Class War is a 9.5% Gotlandrica style ale. It's got honey, juniper berries, and a pearwood smoked malt.
Huh.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's happening at the Off Color Bottle Shop this week. The Illinois Craft Brewers Guild is, they've got a new event, man. It's called Winter Wonderland. Yeah, so Winter Wonderland's going to be in downtown Rosemont. And this is on February 18th. Oh, but tickets go on sale on January 18th, which I believe is like tomorrow, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely, yeah.
Yeah, Wednesday the 18th. So this is out of nowhere, man. They got a new event all of a sudden?
I don't know. I kind of dig that, right?
Good for them, man.
We need some more events. Because otherwise, the show doesn't work.
Yeah, so I'm excited for them. Now, have you been to downtown Rosemont?
No, I didn't know there was a downtown Rosemont.
There is a downtown Rosemont. They got like a thing. They do like free fireworks. They got, you know, stuff for kids. They got, you know.
I've gotten off at the Rosemont CTA stop to go to like a meeting for someone, and I've been to like, I picked someone up from the Morton's, like who?
Yeah, the Morton Steakhouse.
Yeah, right. Who was like staying at that hotel because they were at the airport.
Yeah.
And I know you can take, go over to the casino from right there. Is that like where the downtown is? Or?
Pretty much. So like there's a, you know, there's like a Bub City, there's like a movie theater.
Yeah.
And you know, there's like a music venue, and yeah, like an ice rink that turns into like an outdoor park in the summer.
Okay.
Yeah, it's like a nice little, it's almost like Main Street, you know? It's like
okay.
Five or six restaurants with a really big park in the middle of it, right across the street from where you are.
Okay.
Yeah.
Interesting.
So it's a good time. So let's see what that's about. I'm excited that the guild's getting out there, throwing another event. When I was at the event for, you know, the tattoo event for the rum at the museum.
Yeah.
I ran into one of the brewers at Goose Island.
Okay.
And he was telling me that the guys at the Clybourne Pub, the brewers that are leaving, are actually going to go to Toronto.
Oh.
Yeah, so apparently there was a, they had some guys slotted for the Toronto Brew Pub in Goose Island, but that didn't work out.
That's
so
right. Okay.
It sounds like the guys that were brewing at Clybourne are stepping in and they're going to go up to Toronto and brew up
and
there.
And just like start it off and get it rolling.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah. I wonder, I'm curious to know, like, well, I remember, not that they're going to be brewing 312, but they had a huge issue with 312 when 312 left Chicago.
Right.
Like, because they brewed it in New York and then the water's different in New York. So it affected the taste. They had to dump all of it.
Yeah.
So it makes sense to have, like, you know, your guys up there.
Yeah, but the brew pubs, they never, there wasn't a lot of staples to them. Like, I think their only, like, staple is the 312 blueberry, right?
Oh,
like,
the Cubby Blue.
Cubby Blue. Yeah. That's about it, right?
Yeah, you're right. Yeah.
There's probably a couple others, but I wonder if this may be a role some of those brewers find themselves in. Like, okay, new brew pub opening up in Omaha. Can you go and make sure, like, get the beers going and kind of train the staff on, like, this is how we brew this beer?
Yeah. Yeah. You got to train the trainer, man.
Yeah.
That'd be cool. The good folks at Surly Brewing Company up in Minnesota, they've got marking the inauguration, which is this weekend. It's the 20th, or Friday the 20th, not this weekend. So they're going to have a beer that's an ode to President Obama called Thanks Obama.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a winter rye IPA. Yeah. So they're using some experimental hop that doesn't have a name. They say it carries like a complex, like candied grape, vanilla cream aroma.
Okay.
Yeah. Sounds like a fun time. So, yeah. They're making a beer for the 44th president before it goes out.
Nice.
So, good for them. And finally, in news, the Finch saga finally has an end to it. So they've got a home now.
Right.
This is like a soap opera, man. This is some funny shit, man.
Yeah, what, they're at Like Minds?
Yeah, so they apparently, when you read the story, it sounds like they made Like Minds an offer they can't refuse. So they are going to walk right into Like Minds and just take over the system as is and pick up where they left off.
And Like Minds is moving.
Yeah, so Like Minds was...
They just opened this place.
They just opened the place. I mean, and opened it like, you know, outfitted it, got all the equipment there, you know, set it up to just do their thing, like on a large scale, because they're from Milwaukee and they have space in Milwaukee.
Yeah.
So it sounds like Finch made them an offer that was so sweet that they're like, hey, we're just gonna take this cash and go back to Milwaukee.
And here, Finch is like, well, Goose Island is right here, so people who go to that pub might come to our pub, right? That's the thought process there,
this
right?
This is because this space is literally the old Goose Island storage house. Like, if you went to, like, the 312 block party, this was the block that the block party was on.
Yeah.
It's a block south of Goose's Brewery. Yeah, so he took over that space. Yeah. I wonder why Goose just didn't buy those buildings, you know, because that building alone is larger than, I would say, that 80% of the breweries in town, 90%, size space.
They have the other production brewery, not the production, the bear warehouse. They don't need it, right?
Yeah.
They really don't need it. Like,
yeah.
A lot of the beer is brewed there, but still, it's not. It's brewed in New York. It's brewed elsewhere soon.
Yeah, 312, the IPA. Those beers are brewed at AB plants, mm-hmm. which opened up Fulton for, like, you know, year round Matilda, year round Sophie,
right?
Big volumes of those beers, and then the sisters, of course.
Definitely, yeah.
So look at Finch, man. So for those keeping score at home, this is Finch's third location. They originally were on Elston.
Three, Finch zero.
Elston closed. They moved into Break Room's old space. That place, the Finch Pub, closed. Finch Kitchen, that place closed. And now they're moving into Like Mine's space. They got some deep pockets over at Finch,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, so I wonder what happens with that, but the brew pub space. Because something should go in there, right? But they were auctioning. They were selling everything off.
Yeah,
so
they're selling stuff off. So if you want to do a brewery in there, you got to
get there.
Bring your own stuff.
What do you think? You think this works out for Finch?
I mean,
third time's a charm.
That's one way to look at it, yeah. Right? It's a lot like the Goose Island Fulton or Clybourne space we were talking about. How, you know, yeah, you can make an effort to, like, change the energy of that space, but at the end of the day, it's that space that kind of dictates what's happening there, right? Like, yeah. It's its location that's kind of, you know, that kind of makes it what it is. I think.
I know they had toyed with changing the name when they went to the kitchen.
Yeah.
And I think they should change the name.
Oh, just rebrand all together, Finch.
I think they should just rebrand all together. The name now holds even more negativity than it did when it first launched 5 years ago.
Yeah, I agree with that. I mean, and we talked about it a little bit a couple weeks ago. Like, you know, I don't know if you can come back from that, you know?
Right.
Like, you got off to a bad start, and then you didn't really look out for the Chicago market, even though you were Chicago Brewery. And, you know, we got a lot of pride when it comes to, like, you know, products and stuff made from here.
Yeah.
And then, like, yeah, I think maybe just scrap the whole name.
Oh, yeah.
We even compared it to Argus, how Argus won, like, they won a medal at Great American Beer Fest. But it almost seems like no one seems to care. Even if Finch got their, even if their beers were outstanding and they made a point to have it everywhere readily available, would anyone care at this point? Yeah, that's a fair question.
Yeah, or I think even some goodwill, like, hey, okay, we have the space now. Hey, Arcade, I know you got screwed. Come brew at our space.
Yeah.
And I think they just need some beer cred again.
Yeah, no.
Because they also, remember that, was it last summer where they were like, we're going to open up a waterfront brewery.
It's gonna be the jewel of the Chicago River. Yeah, it's like 75,000 square feet, right on the river. They're wild over there, man. So I mean, it's fun. It's fun for guys like us, you know, because because Finch is just always doing something wacky.
I feel like next week we'll come back and be like, yeah, Light Mines is staying there.
Oh, Finch. Yeah. So that's it for news, man.
All right. Well, I think that does it for Chicago Beer Pass. Yeah. We're going to get out of here, get to some of these events happening this week, and check that out. But Nick, where can people find you, get in touch when you're not recording here?
Right on, man. I'm on Twitter at Nicosio.
And I'm on Twitter at BRad. Chicago Beer Pass is on Twitter at Chicago Beer Pass. But I think Facebook is probably the place where we post the most stuff.
Yeah.
We're sharing photos. We're sharing other events like that you need to get tickets for, like the Chicago Beer Classic or things like that. So check that out, /Chicago Beer Pass. The website, chicagobeerpass.com. All the episodes get posted there. Links to iTunes, Stitcher, the YouTube version as well. And we've also been doing a live stream Periscope version. So check that out if you're free Tuesday nights and want to see the uncut, even though I don't cut anything else. But, yeah, the live version of it. So, yeah, take care.
Cheers.